This video is for electronics assembly engineers, technicians, and managers that are seeking to improve stencil printing. It includes details about how stencil printing and pin and paste with preforms can reduce costs. Dr. Lasky, one of the nemesis of the assembly process has always been printing. It's been chronicled that at least 65% of the defects in the assembly process have been traced back to printing, and in some cases even more. And when we really examine it, we see it comes down to stencil design in a lot of cases. Mm-hmm. So where can a manager or engineer find guidance in this area?
Well, I developed a software tool called StencilCoach, and this will help you design what I call standard apertures. That's apertures for a plastic quad flat pack or a ball grid array. And so you enter things like the thickness of the stencil and the width of the pad, and it'll tell you the aperture for the plastic quad flat pack aperture. And if you enter in the pad diameter, or if it's a square, the side for the ball grid array, it will tell you the right aperture for the ball grid array package. In both cases, it'll help you too with the standards. The standard for the plastic quad flat pack, as you're aware, is an aspect ratio of 1.5, and for a ball grid array package, it's 0.66.
Very good. So it covers all components, whether they're leaded, passives,
right,
area arrays, bottom terminated components.
Yeah. Well, and for passives, there's another special feature. As you're aware, with passives, you can often print too much solder paste,
right,
and you'll get solder balling. And so the software tool has built into it the design parameters for what is called the home plate design.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you use this part of the software tool, it'll help you to successfully design the apertures for passive components so you don't have solder balling.
Very good. So we have aspect ratios, area ratios, excellent. Okay, intrusive soldering, pin and paste, where we're attempting to reflow through-hole components. What about designs for getting adequate solder for those?
Well, you know, that's something the industry is very interested in, because it can save a lot of money. You don't have to do wave soldering, but you do have to print a lot of solder paste. And so part of the tool is such that it'll help you to design the apertures so that you can print enough solder paste. It asks you questions like, what is the diameter of the pin? What is the diameter of the hole, the length of the pin, and so forth. But some cases, this doesn't really work, because you just can't print enough solder paste. So the tool also has another feature in which it'll help you design the apertures, assuming you're using solder preforms. And so you can either try it without preforms first, because that'll save the cost of a preform, but
right,
if it doesn't work for you, then you can use the part of the tool that will help you design with preforms.
Contingency plan,
sure,
excellent. So this is a very versatile, powerful tool. Where can we find it?
You can find this tool at software.indium.com.
Dr. Lasky, thank you.
Thank you.